In this video, I'm going to be talking about Activecampaign landing pages, or what they call Activecampaign pages, and how you can actually use it to grow your email list. So welcome to the video. My name is Burhaan, and let's get right into it. Okay, so first off, Activecampaign has been building this landing page builder for a while now. They launched in beta a couple months ago, and just between you and me, this thing was terrible. I tried doing a video actually about it, but I couldn't get the pages to load. Today though, it's a totally different story. They've obviously done quite a bit of work in the back end, and they've resolved a lot of the issues that they had in the beginning. Once you've created a page and you've got a form on that page, the question always is, how do you connect that page to your list or to your automations on the back end? I'm going to be covering that later on in the video, so definitely stick around. Hit the like button as well if you're liking the content and if you get value out of this video. So let's get into the builder itself. So you can see I've got the landing page up here. Obviously you can sign up for a free trial directly on their website, or you can check out the link in the description to get a free trial for Activecampaign to try out this landing page builder. But essentially this is what it is. It is a landing page builder just like you would normally do, and it'll have elements or components and certain things that you can stick on your landing page to actually build the page out, to create a message, to create a call to action. I'll get into some of the design elements here in a second. Okay, so let's get into the builder itself. And so what I'm going to do is, I've got my Activecampaign account open. I'm going to go to sites, and I'm going to open out the landing page builder. Now, I've already created a few landing pages just to test this feature out. And so we're going to open up one of those pre-designed templates that I used, or I created this particular page from a template. You can see that I've got three different designs here. Two of them are untitled. One of them is the 7-day freelancers workshop, and the page is offline, meaning this page has not been published yet. You can also see that by this little icon where it says page is offline. And these three little dots give you a few more options of getting the URL, meaning you can copy the URL, edit the URL. So if we do that, we can obviously change the URL here in the title. If we want to actually publish the tracking and all of those things, we can do that under settings. So let's have a look at that quickly. So under this particular page settings, this is where you're going to stick the metadata in for SEO purposes. If you want your landing pages to be found by Google, so title, description, keywords, the image for the actual page, which is usually called a featured image if you're coming from WordPress, the favicon count of the page. So this is one of the things. Favicons have to be added for every single page, and so do images. So that's the one thing with using a landing page builder. From a compliance point of view, if you need a cookie banner, Activecampaign will generate one for you. That is quite nice. And then from a custom code point of view, if you need to put your Google Analytics code or Facebook tracking codes or Google AdWords codes or any of the other tracking codes that you want on your page, on your site, then you would add that too. You would use your Activecampaign tracking code here as well. All right, and then if I wanted to choose a template, we've got a couple of different templates. So let's just find, let's just create a new template here. And so this is going to give us the templates that are available in the builder. And these are all pre-built by Activecampaign, none of them in a marketplace. They all look pretty decent. You can browse through those as you go. But I used this landing page generation layout template to make this particular page. So let's get into the page and let's see if I can show you how to get your form connected to the list, and to your automations, and to all of those things. So specifically from a landing page builder, you get what you pay for, right? You get, like, this is the way it works, is you've got sections, you've got columns, and you've got elements, and each of these are blocks, what Activecampaign is calling, and each of these blocks can be customized for the width, right? You can change the padding, change the spacing, the borders, the corners, the drop shadows. Like, you can play around with the design just like you would a normal design, or similar to how you would in Canva. If you wanted to bring extra buttons in on the design, you could do that here. If I wanted to delete that particular block, you've got the delete button. That's the duplicate button, a button, and then keyboard shortcuts under there. So the builder itself is pretty straightforward and self-explanatory. You know, a lot of the builder options are very similar to what you would normally expect from a builder. You know, social links where you would actually connect up your Facebook accounts, and you could choose your icons. You know, all of those things. You could change the layout, for example. You could change the layout of the social icons. You could change the style if you wanted to, change the size. Now, from a sizing point of view, and that the builder is limited, but you know, you can pretty much get away with just editing stuff. If you double click on that, you're gonna have the ability to, you know, change the formatting, put a bold, italic, do all the things that you would normally do on a builder. Now, the main reason for doing this video is to actually show you how to integrate. Now, one of the interesting things about this landing page builder is there are two ways to actually connect up a form. Now, as you would know, if you have an ActiveCampaign or a ConvertKit account, any of these type of accounts, forms are what actually generates the leads. When you have a page like this, it's this form that people will fill in to actually submit the form and send people over. Now, there are two different types of forms. There is this particular subscribe form, which is this one here. And then there's a normal form, which I'm just going to drop here, which you can actually use to have more fields. So for example, here, I've got just a single field. And if I wanted to add a second field, like a first name, maybe the last name, you could generate this form this way as well. Now, obviously you can't have two separate forms, two different design forms on the page, but you can definitely have one style or the other. Now, what's interesting about these particular forms, and you'll see here in the tooltip, is that this subscribe form is what I'm highlighted right now, uses a tag to identify contacts that submit this form or create an automation start trigger. So what it's going to do is ActiveCampaign is going to stick this tag pages dash and then the name of my page, which is up here, 7-day freelancer's toolbox, inside of the contact, right? Now, that doesn't add the person to the list. That doesn't do anything. All it does is it puts the person in your contact list, and then it will tag the person. If you use this form, it's going to use the same tag, or it's going to use the same, yeah, it's going to use the same form, same tag, pages-7 toolbox, which incidentally is exactly the same because it's the same page. That makes sense. So that's how your people are actually going to be landing in your contact list. Now, I'll go into the contact list, or I'll go into an automation to actually show you how to get this this fixed. So what I've got is an automation here, which is starting from scratch, and I'm going to copy this tag from the page. Right click, copy, go over here, paste. And I'm just going to make sure that it's going to hit start, and I'm going to run it once. So now we've got the automation there. What I can then do, because when somebody comes in from that page, they're going to go into the contact list, I want to add them into a list. So I'm going to go to contacts. I'm going to add subscribe to a list. And let's say we've got some sort of a lead magnet, or like, for example, this one here is my 7-day freelancers toolbox. I'm going to hit save. So now when they subscribe, they get a tag, they get added to this list. We have the tag already, but let's say we wanted to add a different tag that's more specific to the toolbox. And so I've got my subscribed tag over here. And then I can continue to send them an email, maybe then wait one day, send another email, wait another day. If they opt in for my newsletter or opt in for my program or whatever it is that I'm selling on this particular newsletter, the 7-day sequence, then I can move them along the automation in that way. And so that's how you would actually set this up, so that you would connect the landing page to the automation so that you can actually send people emails. And that person will be in your contact list that you defined here in this step. And then because of the tag, you can also search for them. So So yeah, that's basically how you're going to use ActiveCampaign landing pages to actually generate leads. You'll drive traffic to that particular landing page. And just to complete the story, if I X out of this particular page and I hit publish, like I said, it's going to publish this page and it's going to give me a link. So if I go to view page settings, you saw earlier where I had the link. Now here's the link over here. It's really, really small, but here's the link over here. And so if I go to this page, you'll see my URL and you'll see all of this. Now, obviously I've clicked it from the inside of the of ActiveCampaign. And so it's got this question mark test equals true at the end. But if I opt in here right now, it's going to go straight into my email list and into my automation once I've got the automation active. Now you can see here it says built with ActiveCampaign. In order to remove that, you need to upgrade to Plus. And then I spoke about the domains as well. This domain feature is locked out for me right now because I'm not upgraded on the Plus plan of ActiveCampaign. Plus or higher is what you need. Here's a page that actually shows you how to connect your domains. And so what you're going to do is you're going to go to domains, add your domain. It's going to give you the CNAME settings inside of the wizard. You go into your DNS settings inside of your domain host and you set up these domain names or the CNAME records inside of that domain name. It'll take a little bit of a while and then the page will be verified, or you can verify the page, and then your page will be published on the domain name that you choose. And basically what's going to happen there is then this domain name will change to the custom domain that you have. Now, another thing that I wanted to actually just highlight, and I'm going to put this link in the description, is this is the Help Center article that actually talks about forms on your ActiveCampaign page, and it gives you the form layout and the notes on what to do with the forms. And it says here the form block does not opt in or add visitors to your email marketing lists. If you wish to add contacts directly to your list or have them go through a double opt-in process, please see how to add an ActiveCampaign form to your landing page. Now, this process to actually add the form to your landing page is what you would normally use. You'd create a form which actually is over here. So you would create a form, you would grab the form, you'd grab the integration code, you'd grab the simple embed, and I'm just gonna copy this. And I'm back on the page. What I'm gonna do from that with that embed link is I am going to look for HTML embed, drag this over, and then this is where we are going to paste the code. So you got to delete that embed code, blah, 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 and stick this this in. Now, the challenge with this type of a thing is the design comes from ActiveCampaign's form builder. And so when you're making changes to this form builder, you've got to make the changes inside of the coding, inside of that form design. What we want to do is we want to use the subscribe form, and I'm going to show you a way right now in the automation to actually get people into the list. So one of the other things about opt-in forms is in order to create a funnel to have somebody opt in on something and then land on a thank you page, it's always nice to have somebody land on a thank you page where you can formally welcome them, or maybe you embed a video and you actually do a video saying thank you, is to actually have them land on that page after they submit. What's nice about ActiveCampaign is on the particular form, you can actually get people to be redirected once they submit the form to land on a second page. Meaning when they submit, you open a page and you can send them to a thank you page. And this would be whatever the URL you want to send them to. Now, if you've built the thank you page inside of ActiveCampaign, you grab the link of that thank you page and you stick it in here. That is right now the only option that you have to actually submit when people submit a form is to actually have them land on a page. The same applies if you take a normal form, and you'll have the settings for this form where on submit you'd either have the default, which is just a normal welcome or a thank you, or you would open the link, and in the same instance you would type in a URL to send people to. If you wanted to publish this page, you hit the publish page, it does these things, It does what it needs to do, and it will generate a link for you. One last thing you might want to do is to unpublish your page if you publish a page that you need to maybe remove. And so I just wanted to show you that for completeness sake. You would open the page builder once the page is published, and you'd click the three dots here in the corner, and you'll click unpublish. Obviously, if you need to rename the page, save the page as a template, get the URL, or if you visit the live page, you could definitely do it over there. Okay, so I hope that was useful. I think I covered all of the different things. I covered the design of the So with that being said, thank you so much for checking this out. I really appreciate you, and good luck with building your landing pages on ActiveCampaign.